Hello YouTube, and welcome to the second part of my technical interview preparation series. Today we will talk about where and how you should start practicing coding for technical interviews. So without any further ado, let's get started. So the first and foremost question which we should try to answer is, where can you start practicing coding interview questions? There are a lot of options available today, both free and paid options for users where you can go and practice coding. And to mention a few, there is HackerRank, there is HackerEarth, there is LeetCode, there is InterviewBit, there is CodeChef, and there are many other websites. And to be honest, you cannot go wrong with any one of these, because all of them have different styles of teaching you coding, and eventually most of the contents is same on those websites. But I'm not here to give a general recommendations. I'm here to help you out, finalize one of them and start coding on it. So based on my experiences and based on reading a lot of content online and some online research, the website I would recommend is LeetCode. There are basically two reasons why I would do that. Number one reason is, I've used this term before and I would try to use it again. And the thing is, LeetCode has kind of become an industry standard for a lot of companies. Initial couple of coding rounds, and you would often read experiences saying, hey, I was given a LeetCode medium problem, or hey, I was given a LeetCode hard problem in my interview. So that is there. Number two is, because the website is so widely used, there is a lot of published guidance on how you should go ahead and in what sequence you should try to solve problems on LeetCode, and what kind of patterns are there for LeetCode problems, which would cover most of the problems on LeetCode, and other guides like this. And we'll cover all of them shortly when we jump over on the system. But yeah, the website of choice is LeetCode. So let's talk about a very important thing which will help you a lot in your LeetCode journey. I always used to think, similar to design patterns, are there patterns of coding interview questions also? Like, can you map each of the coding interview questions to one of the types of patterns in which it can be solved and then approach the problem? And luckily the answer is yes. There is a course called Grokking the Coding Interview, and we'll get into that in a little while. And the beauty of that course is it tries to categorize almost all problems which you will find on LeetCode into 16 kind of coding patterns by which they can be solved. So suddenly, out of like 1,000 random questions, you can actually categorize all of those questions into one of the solution patterns or approaches and then try to solve it. So following this or knowing this before jumping into LeetCode problems helped a lot in actually having to design a solution approach and having to think a solution approach in one of these 16 patterns, as compared to just randomly trying to come up with a solution for the problem. I would recommend you buy the course, and the course actually talks about the patterns with specific examples in details. If you cannot buy the course, don't worry. I will link an article in the description where the author kind of summarizes all the 16 patterns, and he kind of gives you the idea and the essence of what kind of 16 patterns are there. Apart from practicing coding interview questions, you should also be aware of what is being asked in the latest interview experiences. So for that, my recommendation is the website Geeks for Geeks. It is a brilliant website, and one of the beautiful part of the website is it gives a summary of all the latest interview experiences by people and what are the latest interview questions which are asked for interviews of different companies. And that can help you give an idea of what are the current questions or the current types of questions being asked for any given company, say Amazon, Microsoft, Google, Facebook, and others.
So as discussed before, let's now check out all the resources which I mentioned in my video one by one. So the very first course which I mentioned was Grokking the Coding Interview. This is a course on educative.io, where you will find out about the 16 coding patterns. And this course, actually you can see in the course summary what are the 16 patterns, and if you choose to buy the course, there are problems related to each pattern, there are challenges, there are first examples and then challenges. So this is a very good course to understand the coding interview question patterns. If you do not wish to buy this course, don't worry. I found another article. So this is an article which somewhat summarizes 14 of the coding patterns. And most of these are similar to the ones which are mentioned in Grokking the Coding Interview. So this is a very useful article and please refer to it. All right, next up, let's jump into the recommended sequence in which we should solve lead code questions. Since the developer community who uses this website is so huge, there are a lot of sequences developers have themselves published of questions on lead code which should be used for technical interview preparation. I will go over a few lists over here. So the very first list which I want to talk about is lead code's own list of top interview questions. So this is a list which consists of 145 easy, medium and hard problems, which is most frequently asked in technical interviews by top companies. So this list can be divided into three kinds of lists, sublists, if you may. Each of the sublists is a collection of easy, medium and hard problems. So as you can see, this is the collection for easy lead code problems. This is a collection of medium lead code problems, and this is a collection of hard lead code problems. So this is a very good list to get started on lead code. The other list which I would want to mention is, for example, this is a list of around 170 questions where somebody had solved around 500 questions and they had picked the top 170 questions which are kind of unique and useful. So there's this one. There is another list of 75 curated list of questions. So there's this. Also, there is another 5-week list of questions published on this website. So if you are short on time, like you have 4-5 weeks, then you can probably get started with this one. So other than these lists, there are a lot of other lists which are published by developers. The idea is very simple. Pick anyone and get started with it instead of getting confused in which one to pick. My recommendation would be to get started with the top interview questions, which is published by lead code itself, and solving these 145 easy, medium and hard collections. There's a very important site which I wanted to mention, which is Geeks for Geeks. In general, you can use this website for tutorials, for questions, but I specifically found that you can greatly complement your interview preparation, which you are doing by solving questions on lead code, with the interview question section, which is present on Geeks for Geeks for latest interview experiences. So to go to the latest interview experiences, you need to click on tutorials, interview corner, go to interview experiences. Here, for example, they have clubbed all the latest interview experiences of different candidates who voluntarily come and share their experiences under the company's umbrella. So for example, if I want to see, say, Amazon, I'll click on Amazon and here I can find out, say, what is the latest interview experience for an SD position for a candidate who is 1.5 years experienced. Your experience may vary and it may be different. So yeah, go ahead and check out the relevant interview experience which is applicable for you. So here you can see what are the latest questions being asked in Amazon interviews. So yeah, by any means, this is not the exact questions which are answered, but you should get some idea of what kind of questions are being asked in technical interviews. Before signing off, I would also want to mention one last website, which I think can be quite useful. The website is called InterviewBit. And here also, I really like the way in which they approach teaching you data structures and algorithms. So for example, for a given topic, let's pick arrays. So first they will present a bunch of tutorials on that topic, and then they present a set of problems which are asked in different company interviews. And when you go over a problem, they actually simulate an interview experience and you have to solve that problem under the stipulated time which is mentioned. So for example, if a problem is to be solved in 43 minutes, that is the average time which people took to solve that problem. If you solve earlier, there is a whole point system which you earn more points, and then you can unlock hints and everything. So yeah, I mean, overall, it's a very good option if you have additional time apart from lead code. Good option to explore.
I hope you guys found the video useful. If you found it helpful, please like the video and please share it with your friends and others so that more and more people can see it and benefit from it. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.